So this is our first question. The LVDT is used for the measurement of. So first we have to know something about LVDT. So LVDT is linear variable differential transformer. It is one type of transformer and it is also a transducer. So what is the transducer? Transducer is a device that converts any type of signal into electrical signal. Basically, for the measurement purpose, we can measure the electrical quantities very easily using our ammeter, voltmeter, etc. So if we can convert any types of signal into electrical signal using transducer, that will be easy for the measurement purpose. Look at here. This is the construction of LVDT. Here two types of coils are there. One is primary coil. This is the primary coil, and both sides there are two secondary coils. At the middle position there is the core. LVDT is used to measure the displacement. It can measure a little displacement. This is the circuit diagram of LVDT. Here is the primary coil and here is the two secondary coils are present here. The working principle is that if we move this core from downward to upward, more amount of flux will link with this coil. So V1 will be more than V2, and these two coils are electrically connected in such a way that output voltage will show the difference between V1 and V2. So with the help of this quantity, we can calibrate the displacement and we can measure the displacement very easily. If the core moves downward, at that case more amount of flux will link with this secondary coil, so V2 will be higher than V1. So this is the working principle of LVDT. Now come back to the questions. LVDT is used to measure of. It will measure the displacement. So obviously option D is the correct answer. The next problem is a numerical problem. A milliammeter of 3 ohm resistance read a maximum current of 150 milliampere. It can be used as a voltmeter to read up to 15 volt by. It was a meter like this. There is a series internal resistance of 3 ohm connected with it. We have to convert this ammeter into a voltmeter. So we must have to connect a series resistance, as because the internal resistance of voltmeter should be high, or internal resistance of ammeter should be less. So this is series resistance. As we have to connect the series resistance, so obviously we can cancel option A and option B. So the answer will be either option C or option D. Suppose this is R, the value of this series resistance. So now go to the calculation part. Okay. So here says that maximum current of 150 milliampere can pass through the meter, and now it will read 15 volt. So obviously current 150 milliampere, so 10 to the power minus 3 multiplied by 3 plus the external series resistance, that is R, it will equals to the current multiplied by the resistance, it will equal to the voltage, that is 15 volt. So by solving this, we can calculate very easily. So now R will equals to 100 minus 3, that will equals to 97 ohm. So is the correct answer option D is the correct answer, connecting a series of 97 ohm with the meter. Option D, that is the correct answer. Let's move to the next question. Which transducer has very nonlinear and high temperature coefficient characteristics? Here four name of four transducers are given here: thermistor, pyrometer, thermocouple and thermometer. So first we need to know basics about these four transducers. Let's start. First is the thermocouple. Thermocouple, thermo means it is related with the heat, and couple means two wires made with different metal are coupled here. Okay, here is two junction. One junction is called the hot junction. We have to touch this junction with the body whose temperature need to be measured, and this is the cold junction. We should maintain a very low temperature at that junction. So suppose we touch this junction with a high temperature body, a high temperature difference will create between hot junction and cold junction. So the current will flow here. Current will flow through the meter, and a voltmeter is present here. It will measure the voltage, and the calibration will give the temperature value of this hot junction. So this is the working principle of thermocouple: measure temperature. And applications are there. It is used to measure the gas turbine exhaust and diesel engine for measuring the temperature of these kinds of high temperature body. This thermocouple is used. Next one is the thermistor. It is also used to measure temperature, but it has some different properties. It is made with metal oxide. We can use manganese oxide for making a thermistor. It is basically a non-linear device. The semiconductors are non-linear, we know that, and it has negative high temperature coefficient. Negative temperature coefficient means if we increase the temperature, its resistance value will decrease. Okay, normal devices, normal metals have positive temperature coefficient. If we increase the temperature of a metal like aluminium, copper, etc., its resistance will increase, but in this case its resistance will decrease. And the application of thermistors is that it is used on fire alarm, oven, refrigerator, digital thermometer. Okay, the next one is the pyrometer. The basic difference between pyrometer and thermistor and thermocouple is that we can measure the temperature of a hot body without touching that body using the pyrometer. Temperature of hot body, like high temperature body like boiler, furnace, etc., contains very high temperature. So we can't touch these kinds of hot body. The working principle is that a lens, this is convex types of lens. Obviously, a radiation comes out from the hot body, which when falls on this lens, and the radiation concentrated on a particular black body. So the temperature of that black body becomes very high. So current starts to flow. If we use a meter, either ammeter or voltmeter, that can measure the current flowing through it. So with the help of calibration, we can measure the temperature of that hot body using pyrometer. Okay, so the transducer has very nonlinear and high temperature coefficient characteristics. The answer is the thermistor. Only the thermistor So the answer is that thermistor. Only the thermistor is used to, thermistor made with the semiconductor devices. So it is non-linear and it has negative and high temperature coefficient. Next question is from CRO. Lissajous figure. So first see what is the Lissajous figure. This diagram basically shows how will be the shape of Lissajous figure if we vary the phase difference between two applied signals. For creating the Lissajous figure, we apply two sinusoidal signals on the x-axis and y-axis of the CRO, and finally it makes either a ellipse, a circle or a straight line. When the phase difference between two signals are zero, then it creates this straight line. When phase difference zero, when phase difference is between 0 to 90, then it creates a ellipse with clockwise direction. This direction is clockwise here. When the phase difference is between 90 to 180 degree, then also ellipse, direction is same clockwise. And for 90 degree, it creates a circle with clockwise direction. At 180, it makes a straight line. When phase difference between 180 and 270, creates an ellipse, then circle, then ellipse again. How to remember this all? We have to remember, just remember this figure, and then remember from the x-axis, upward is clockwise, downward is anti-clockwise. Okay. Look at this diagram. When phase difference is between 0 to 90 degree, these kinds of ellipse are generated as Lissajous figure. So how to measure the phase difference here? Look at this formula. Phi is the phase difference between two applied signals is equals to sine inverse x intersect by x max. In this figure, this is x intersect x sine and x max the maximum value of x axis. The phase is also can be measured using this formula y intersect by y max. Remember every time y intersect or x intersect always will be less than y max and x max consecutively. And this formula gives a relation between frequency of two applied signals nx. Nx means at how much points it cut the x axis. Look at this figure. In this figure, this figure cuts the x-axis or meet with the x-axis at two points. So nx equals to 2 here and meet with the y-axis 4 points. This is the maximum meet, maximum number of meet. If the figure is like this, suppose the figure is, this is figure is like this. So maximum number of point meet with y-axis, it will be 2 for x-axis. It will be 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. Okay. So remember this formula. Problems may come from this formula also. Now come back to the questions. Lissajous figure appears on CRO screen when two sine waves of same frequency are applied, depends on amplitude of two input signals, depends on amplitude of two input signals, depend on phase of two input signals. Obviously, it is phase dependent. By varying the phase, we can get different shapes of Lissajous figure. The next question says that the Q-meter is an instrument to measure inductance, to measure capacitance, to measure ratio of reactance to resistance, to measure frequency. Q-meter, the name says that the Q, it is used to measure the quality factor. From the concept of circuit theory, we know that is omega L divided by R. This is the quality factor. This Q meter is especially used to measure the quality factor of inductive circuits. So obviously, this is the ratio of reactance to resistance. So option C will be the correct answer. Q meter basically measures the quality factor at the resonance condition. So last two problem is as your home task. Please solve this problem from yourself and comment at the comment section. The problem is that voice is not measured by frequency meter. Next problem is the first Fourier transform analysis can be measured using. Take the screenshot of these two problems and then solve and comment at the comment section. Okay.